Hi everyone, Susan here for diversions.com. I've got the exciting March 2012 release here to show you. Well, I've got some of the dies to show you. This is going to be coming out March 1st on Wednesday, and I wanted to show you a couple of the dies. We have a full release this month of Whispers. Whispers are very detailed, very intricate die cuts. You can see here is the spring parasol. Lots of detail. This is the Fleur de Lis. Very detailed, and I love this very intricate, almost polka dotty kind of an eyelet edged effect. And then this is the chrysanthemum. It's lots of dots around the edges, but lots of nice open spaces. Three, four things that I have to use when I'm using the Whispers dies is you're going to want to have something. This is one of our picks and pokes, which is a set of five tools that have very sharp little heads poking out the negative spaces of the cardstock. I also use a pen type adhesive. This is the little ballpoint pen, not the felt tip. I like this one because it's very precise and gets under those individual line cuts of the die cut. I also use a lot of scotch removable tape and a nice big chunky fingernail file. This is a brand new one that I don't use it for anything else except for my paper stuff, and you'll see where I use this here in a few minutes. Okay, because these are such intricate dies, it requires a lot of pressure, okay? A lot of pressure is achieved, extra pressure is achieved by shimming your die. And the reason these need to be shimmed is not because these are poor quality. It's because they're so high quality, they can actually cut very intricate pieces. But the blades are very close together. I mean, some of these blades in there, the cuts, the blades, the knife, however you want to refer to it, they're very close. Some of them are 16th of an inch apiece, apart. Some of these little holes here are 16th inch apart. So because those blades are so close, you have to increase the pressure in order to make both of them come into contact with the rollers and thereby cut your paper. So usually, if you can get a great cut from a very intricate die, it means it's a very high quality. There is a learning curve when cutting these intricate dies. If you used any spell binders, they are a perimeter cut die, most of them. You know, they cut one shape, one shaped oval, circle, label, something like that, a nesting shape. These are completely different. These are not going to cut like a spellbinder's die. These have lots of intricate, detailed, woven, interlaced interior cuts, and if we were just cutting an exterior shape, that would be no problem. But once you start cutting the interior cuts that are this detailed and this intricate, you have to work with them accordingly, okay? And how we do that is by shimming our dies. Every machine is going to be different. This is a Big Shot, and I've had this since December, so that may only sound like it's 2.5 months old, but actually, this went to CHA with me, so it's had thousands of cuts run through it, okay? Based on your machine, the age of your machine, the age of your cutting plates, your machine might be differently. So that's why we say you have to experiment a little bit. How I work with my machine is I know that I use my multi-purpose platform. Both the tabs are down, so everything is solid and closed here in the multi-purpose. One clear cutting plate on the bottom. And then you can see that my top cutting plate is pretty warped. This is the second one I've gone through. But that's okay. That's going to affect the way it cuts. Now, I know from working with this die so much last week that it takes three pieces of cardstock white patterned paper to cut this. This is just American Crafts cardstock white paper. Okay, so it's heavier than a real thin paper, but it's we say cardstock weight. So I've got three pieces here. Let's see how this works on the umbrella, the parasol, and then I'll show you also how it works with our metal adapters. Okay, so I've got my cardstock pattern side down, and I like to do, when I'm using paper shims, I like to put mine on top of the cutting mat. It just, I can keep an eye on it, I remember that it's there, and I can keep track of if it slips or slides as it's going through. Okay, now I'm going to get it through there, and then don't be afraid to go back and forth. You don't want to go over the edge because that would cause your die to possibly move, but I am just rolling it back and forth in the center of the die because the center is where you're going to have the hardest time cutting, and then you can hear it pop over the edge. Okay? So here's my spring parasol in a lovely lime green. Actually, this is kind of a chartreuse. The first thing I like to do is just kind of flick it like this. It'll get the biggest cuts out, the biggest pieces. Now you have to remember, when you're at this stage, you're kind of talking like, you remember the game Barrel of Monkeys? You're getting, look at these intricate, look at these, how these are all interwoven. I mean, you've got, it's like a jigsaw. And so you do have to do some popping of the pieces in order to get them out. And that's just a byproduct of what we're asking the dies to do, okay? So when it comes to the littler pieces, it's just a matter of popping. And I'm just taking the end of my poker here. This is my pick and poke. But it's just a matter of poking them out. I'm not even pressing. It's just poking it through the cardstock. Okay, so this is working with my Big Shot. And that was 3 shims of cardstock weight pattern paper. Now we also sell what we call a metal adapter. Metal adapter is, and they're sized for the machine, the specific machine. Okay. So we'll do that here in a second. Okay, so there is my, let's put a piece of paper on it. There is my spring parasol. You can see that those pieces all cut perfectly. There we go. There's the tip. I'm like, that doesn't look right in the camera. Okay, now what I wanted to show you here is a lot of times you get extra pieces here. If you use this little emery board and brush over, and I'm not filing, I'm just flinging, just very, very lightly flinging, and those pieces will come out. And if you've got one that still sticks, just touch it, and there you go. Okay, so that's how I clean off that. Let's do another cut from our May release. I love this one. I love this chrysanthemum. Okay, so let's do the, this is the metal shim, okay? It looks like this. It's a piece of metal. But it will start to warp also, just like your mat does, okay, because it's so thin. So I'm going to put that on the bottom. When I'm using the metal shim, you want to do that on the bottom, just because it's too hard to finagle going through the rollers. So that goes down. And again, I'll still just kind of rock this back and forth in the center, just to the edge. And you can feel it. You'll know your machine when it starts to pop over the edge. Okay. Here's the chrysanthemum. Love this die. And this, oh, it looks so good just on a square of cardstock. And see, this is where you talk about the barrel of monkeys. I mean, you can't just, all those are not going to just fall out because they're all interwoven. So this one, this is what I call my 3-minute therapy, is you just poke. Now, they're not falling off the back. And I'm going to show you how to get rid of that. If you poke all these, just pierce your poker. Okay, so we'll do a couple of these. And if you'll see, they're kind of still like what we say, they have our little cling-ons there in the back. Turn it over, and then again, very smoothly and very lightly. I'm barely pressing. But all you want to do is you want the fibers of this emery board to catch, and then it will smooth off those backs, all those little snags. What did they call those in the election? The hanging chads. So poke all those. Here's another one. Let's poke these centers out, and these are curvy, so these are going to be a little, you have to kind of wrestle with those, and it's just the paper grabbing onto the paper because the shapes are curved. And again, then just swipe over there. There we go. So this emery board trick, I think, is really awesome. All right, so there we go. There is the chrysanthemum. Now, when you look at the details of those lines, I mean, these lines are very, very thin. Look at them in comparison to my piercer. Look at how thin those lines are. So when you're working, whether you're working with a metal shim, the metal adapter on your Big Shot, or whether you're working with a couple pieces of pattern paper, the results can be the same. I started using this metal shim. I didn't get one until we were in California at CHA. And once I started using it, I was like, to heck with my paper shims. This is just easier. It's just easier for me. But as you can see, when I did this first one, the parasol, it cuts just beautifully with the paper shims. This is just going to be a little bit more durable. If you have any questions, feel free to email me at susan@diversions.com. Don't forget the hyphen, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible.